Mayor Seiler, describe for us the situation right now here locally.
Well, I think you have a community that's been definitely kept informed, definitely notified of the risks, the hazards. And so, you know, this storm has been so big for so long and has been talked about for 3-4 days that I think everybody is aware of it. There isn't anybody that said, oh my God, we have a hurricane coming. I mean, everybody knows it, whether it's the Sun-Sentinel coverage, you know, the state coverage, the national coverage, people know it's coming. So I think our neighbors are informed, they're advised, they're notified, and they need to, you know, they know what they need to do. I think the other issue is after what just happened in Texas, there is a much more relevant element to it, because I think Texas caught everybody by surprise. And Texas, that, you know, the storm hit Texas and hung around, and it was national news for 3, 4, 5 days. And then coming off that national news finally ending, here comes Irma. And I think that's what's kept this issue about hurricanes on the forefront. The big thing I've been trying to explain to people is the difference between the two storms. The storm that hit Texas was a tremendous rain element. Tragic, terrible, you know, catastrophe what took place there. But it was rain. It was rain that hung around.
It hovered and it
flooded, and it just hung around. What we're going to see here is so different, and I think David will probably touch on this a little bit, as you know, with his environmental background. This is a storm surge element. This is something that we see more as a storm surge, where you're going to see the wind coming out of the east. You're going to potentially see our high tides, and we're just getting into seasonal high tides. You know, we always talk about September, October, November being our king tide season. So now you're getting into the high tides, potential high tides. You've got a full moon out there. And if you get that wind pushing out of the east with a seasonal high tide, and then you get that storm surge coming, pushing with this massive storm, we're looking at a potential, you know, serious coastal flooding, not necessarily caused by rain, but more likely caused by rising sea coming across. And that's been the big concern of mine as the mayor. That's been the real issue we've been looking at, because we'll survive the rain. I mean, we've been here 100 and some years as a city. We've survived hurricanes and heavy rain. But the wind, as David indicated earlier, hitting numbers that we don't see numbers up above 150 by the time they hit us, and this storm surge, that's what's concerning us at the city of Fort Lauderdale. That's why we believe the barrier island needed to be evacuated, why we now have police officers posted at the entrance to the barrier island, advising people they need to stay off the barrier island. Most people have listened to us. I think we've been talking very closely, Sheriff Israel and his team. Many people may not know, but the undersheriff to my right was actually the former assistant chief in Fort Lauderdale.
Oh.
Tremendous public servant and professional police officer. We've been talking, and we'll be enforcing a curfew on the barrier island and then countywide, but we specifically will be enforcing that curfew tomorrow night. Making sure as the storm comes in, as again indicated, more of a Saturday into Sunday thing, we want to keep people off the barrier island.